We are from group 4 and now we are going to present our assignment, which is Production of Vinyl Acetate. Now I am going to discuss my part, which is sustainable production of vinyl acetate from three different aspects, which is economic aspect, environmental aspect, and society aspect. First of all, vinyl acetate is produced through an oxidation process, as you can see from here, and it is made up of reactants from acetic acid, ethylene, and oxygen, while having iodine as our catalyst. So our end product will be vinyl acetate and water. As I mentioned above, we will use a catalyst named palladium. Palladium as our catalyst. Palladium plays an important role in improving the conversion and the selectivity of the process. It will actually lower the temperature and pressure of the process to around 159 degrees Celsius and 620 Kelvin. So by lowering the temperature and pressure, we will actually reduce the energy usage for the heater, for the heating and pumping duties. So by lowering the heating and pumping duties, what we can do is that we can cause profitability enhancement because the operating costs are reduced by reducing the energy consumption. Apart from that, in our production process of vinyl acetate, it is a well-known fact that we all the reactants will not be transformed into the products at the end of the reaction. So in this case, we use a distillation column to separate the unreacted reactant, which is acetic acid and ethylene, from the abundant products. And then we recycle the ethylene and acetic acid back to the feed. By doing this, we actually save a lot of production costs if the unreacted ethylene, which is our raw material, can be recycled back to the feed stream. By saving production costs, our overall profit will receive an unprecedented boost. To add to that, by recycling the unreacted reactants back to the feed stream, we actually have both economic and environmental benefits. We can avoid the disposal of the unreacted products such as ethylene and acetic acid as waste to the environment, and it may cause pollution to the environment because ethylene will actually affect the crop yield of plant by affecting the plant form. And then inhalation of ethylene to our equipment will actually cause us to be dizziness, unconsciousness, and so on. For the society aspect, one of the crucial factors that we choose to produce vinyl acetate is that because there is large demand from all around the world, and by doing this, we will actually fulfill the society. One of the crucial factors that we chose to produce vinyl acetate is that we will actually fulfill the society needs due to the large demand from all around the world. For your information, vinyl acetate is actually an intermediate to produce the topping and packaging like paint and so on. Statistics show that Asia-Pacific region is the fastest growing market due to the ridiculously high demand from industry like coating and paint in China and India. This is because both the countries have the largest economic market and lower production costs. That's all for me.
The advantages is any water introduced in the reaction will be absorbed disadvantage is the increasing value of the acetylene will cause the process to be prohibited. Based on three pathways, we eliminated the second pathway, which is the pathway from the methanol and the syngas because of the high cost.
Okay, so for me, my name is Chan Tai Fong. I will explain about the chemical compounds, about the components that we use. So as you can see, the raw material is a few raw material here for the reaction A and reaction C. So we can see that carbon dioxide, water, and oxygen, these three components is actually having no value for the components. And then we can see the vinyl acetate as our product is $1.5 per ounce. Then here I've done some computing gross profit for the both reactions. So for this reaction, reaction A, we can see the gross profit is 60 cents per pound of the VAC. And then for the reaction C, we can see that the gross profit is 45 cents per pound. So in conclusion, after comparing these two, we can see that the reaction A is actually more profitable because it's having a higher profit. So next, go for CPAP.
So here is the preliminary flowchart for the selective pathway A, and this is a flowchart. And then the distribution of the chemical, our target is to produce 105,000 metric tons per year. So by using the calculation, we calculated out the total feed, including the raw material and the actual recycled stream is 228.4 metric tons per hour. But the reactor parameter, in the commercial reactor, the pressure is recommended at 90 psi and the temperature is 158.9 degrees Celsius. Because of the presence of the catalyst of palladium, it cannot resist the temperature of 200 degrees Celsius. While the option B is the feed stream containing only the raw materials such as the ethylene, SAC, and the oxygen without any recycled stream. So this is in conclusion, the option B is rejected because it does not have the recycled stream and will increase the cost.
So for my part, I eliminate the difference in the composition. For all the raw material here stated and also with the product with acetate, I've done some properties for this, including the boiling point at 180 critical temperature and critical pressure. So by following all these properties, there is some analysis for this, which is option A, it's a direct sequence. The direct sequence is actually follow ascending with the volatility, which is start from oxygen, ethylene, carbon dioxide, acetate, water, until acetic acid. And then next will be the option. So this one is actually a diagram showing how the direct sequence for the B. Then we have another option, which is an indirect sequence. So the indirect sequence is actually following the descending order of the volatility of all the components, which is start from acetic acid, water, vinyl acetate, carbon dioxide, ethylene, until the last water. So in conclusion, that is this option one, direct sequence will be more profitable because we are using less energy usage and then less money and less cost for these reactions to happen. Thanks.
So for the eliminating the difference in the temperature, pressure, and the phase, the heater is used to increase the temperature and pressure to convert the liquid phase into the vapor phase, while the cooler is used to cool the vapor phase into the liquid phase for the transferring purpose and for the easier separation. And the second option is that all the temperature are set as tight as possible and all are exist in the vapor phase. And this is not recommended because of the option D, use all the vapor phase and it's not recommended because due to the heuristic, the gases must be compressed into the air, then compressed into the liquid phase so that it isn't transferring. So this is a diagram for the flowchart.
Okay, so this is actually the integrated task and the development of the base case. So what simply means by the integrated task is actually adding the unit operation into the process flow diagrams. As you can see, there is four unit operations has been added, which including heater, cooler, mixer, and also a compressor. So for this, adding the unit operations is actually under the option A. So option A is actually more preferable because all these unit operation adders can actually help to reduce the time for the production of the vinyl acetate and also increase the reactions. So for option B, you can save some money for the installation of the unit operation and also maintenance. But this is not recommended because it will occur some error or problems to the reactions sometimes. So this is not recommended. So option A has been chosen. So at last, the synthesis tree has been built up. So from here we can see that at first we are start from reaction A, and then next towards the four changes we have choose option A also. So at last, option A, the integrated task has been chosen as our last finishing. So that's all from us. Thank you.
Today I'm going to present about the separation transsynthesis. The purpose of the separation transsynthesis is to identify the best sequence for the separation train. There are four methods to identify the separation train, which are heuristic, minimum vapor flow, marginal vapor flow, and the analyzed cost. The method discovered in this case are heuristic method and marginal vapor flow method. Based on the calculation, the number of sequences we obtain is 42 sequences. However, in this case, we have only 2 sequences due to a few components are separated together at one time. The heuristic method, first of all, oxygen is removed according to heuristic 3 as the component has the greatest molar ring. Secondly, ethylene is reduced according to the decreasing molar ring. Okay, next, carbon dioxide is removed based on heuristic 1 as it is a corrosive component. After that, the desired component, vinyl acetate, is removed because it has a greater volatility compared to water and acetic acid. And then lastly, water is eliminated and followed by acetic acid, which has the lowest volatility.
Thank you. acetate. So here we have the two hot stream and also three cold stream. So the purpose of doing this heat and energy integration is to develop the HEM, the new heat exchange network that consumes the minimum amount of EDPs and require the minimum number of exchangers for the full energy recovery. So now this table shows the supply temperature and the target temperature as well as the CP value and the heat EDPs in each of the cold stream and the hot stream, which can be obtained from the calculation as well as the missing information provided. And now, in order to identify the pinch location, I'm using the PTA method, which is the probe table algorithm. So, the first step in this method is to find the shift temperature in the bowl. In order to find the shift temperature in the bowl, I need to find the shift supply temperature and also the shift target temperature. Assuming that the theta T min is 10 degrees Celsius, and we divide the theta T min with 2, and we get 5 degrees Celsius. For the hot stream, I need to subtract the stream to be colder. And for the cold stream, I need to add the theta T min divided by 2 to make the stream hotter. And I will get this table. So the next step, I'm going to form a heat energy balance. And from this heat energy balance, I'm using the shift temperature to arrange accordingly from the top to the bottom in the bigger temperature value to the lowest temperature value. And I will draw the stream population. And later, then I will find the interval temperature. And from the interval temperature, I will find each of the net CP value by using the CP of hot stream minus the CP of cold stream. And from the theta T and the net CP value, I can find the energy in each temperature interval. So, the energy usage is being used to form the heat cascade table, whereby the heat cascade table, the first table is being start with the zero energy. And we add and multiply accordingly according to the theta H we obtain. And from this one, negative 221.84.378 is the largest heat deficit and will be used in as the starting heat in the second table. And from the result of this table, we can notify that at temperature 109, so from the result of this second heat cascade table, there is a zero energy, which is at a temperature of 129.20 degrees Celsius. And this one will be your pinch temperature. In order to obtain the hot pinch temperature, you need to add this 109.20 with 5 degrees Celsius to obtain 114.20. And the cold stream, obviously you need to minus 5 and get 104.20. And the key, and the minimum hot humidity is calculated in this table will be 21.84.378 kilowatt, and the cold humidity will be 3492.589 kilowatt. So now we are proceeding in the pinch design method. First of all, I need to create a quick diagram. With my quick diagram, I have arranged two hot streams at the above and followed by three cold streams. Then I separate this hot stream and cold stream at the middle point, which according to the pinch temperature, the hot pinch temperature and the cold stream temperature. So now I'm going to do the heat recovery action at the above pinch first. First of all, there's only at the above pinch, there's only one hot stream that I can provide the heat energy to three cold stream. But the H2 cannot provide the energy to C1 because the CP value is higher than the CP of H2 is higher than CP of C1, which is not follow the CP inequalities. So the energy from H2 will be transferred to C4 first as 3397.08 kilowatt, and the temperature of the H2 will now drop, will now increase to 140.90. So now all the heat 397.08 kilowatt energy is being transferred from the hot stream 2 to C4. And now the C4, all the heat energy in the C4 is fully recovery and the C4 is being taken off. So we proceed to another stream away from the pinch. So the remaining energy from the H2 is being transferred to C5, whereby all the energy in the H2 is being transferred fully to the C5. Then the H2 can be taken off as well. So the remaining C5 and C1 there is still energy needed in order to cool the temperature to the required target temperature. So we need to install another two heater there. So the above pinch HDM is completed, then we move to the below pinch. At the below pinch there, same, we need to follow the CD inequality rules as well. Here we have two hot streams which can provide the energy to one cold stream. However, the HD cannot provide the heat to C1 because the temperature, because the CP is lower than the C1, which does not obey the rules. So the energy from the H2 is being transferred to C1. And the C1 energy is fully recovering and can be taken off. So now the remaining H2 energy and the H3 energy need to be added into cooler in order to cool it to the required target temperature. So at this one, the below pinch, the HDM is also complete as well. So we form the overall complete HDM. We combine the upper pinch network and the below pinch network together. And this one is the complete network. And I've drawn it out in the PMP form. So this one is the modified PMP after the heat integration. So that's all for my part. Thank you.